晒观众，大家好，欢迎收睇《大城小爵》。其实咧，加拿大嘅皇室咧都会定期咧批一啲勋章咧，俾啲对社会特别有贡献嘅人士啦，或者组织嘅。哇，好犀利系咪？好多朋友咧谂过，有冇谂过你咧？其实都可能咧可以攞到一个咧加拿大颁发嘅一个勋章，一个荣誉勋章。咁原来咧加拿大咧嘅市民咧都可以咧睇下你嘅贡献或者成就咧，可以去申请呢啲勋章噶。咁但系呢啲勋章嘅制度咧都系吓几复杂、几繁复下噶，所以我哋今日咧好开心咧，可以请到咧呢个前任嘅首席勋章官员啦，啊 Mr. Robert Watts 啦，同埋咧其中一位咧我哋华人之光啊，可以攞到咧佢自己一个荣誉勋章嘅啊 Mr. Tung Chang 啊陈志栋先生咧，上嚟同我哋分享一下啦。Welcome everybody，welcome。
Hello Emily，thank you。
咁嗱，大家咧首先可以睇到我哋今日现场咧就有一个图画啦，好靓啦，系一个勋章嚟噶。原来咧个勋章个制度啦，同埋呢个勋章本身嗰個形狀啊，設計咧都好特別，有好多嘅含義喎，好多層唔同嘅含義啊！等我同我哋嘉賓咧傾下偈先。So Mr. Watts, welcome. I'll call you Robert from now on.
Yes, please.
Let's just talk about this whole idea. I know what a coat of arms is, but then I did a little research. It's quite a complicated thing. Can you give us a little background of like what is a coat of arms? And I've heard about people talking about a memorial crest. What are the differences?
Yes. Well.A coat of arms is basically a symbol. It's a symbol of identity, and it originated over 800 years ago in what's now part of France and Belgium. And it came into being because, for two reasons, basically, knights on the battlefield or in tournaments needed identification. If they were all wearing the same kind of armor, if you think of a hockey game, maybe or any other kind of game, there had to be something in the end to distinguish what some people have said to the good guys from the bad guys. And so this form of art, and they placed it on shields, exactly like this one, which belongs to Tung, but the origins are that old. And so it was a form of art that was invented to help people tell who was who on the battlefield in tournaments. And then the other reason was for land transactions and inheritance. If people were passing on land or other kinds of property in the Middle Ages, these forms of symbols were very useful because they could appear on a ring or a seal. And so you could just drip wax and go like bong, like that. And used across the generations, it established a family connection, generation by generation, with a particular person or and their descendants, basically. So a very old idea, originally from Europe, but now it's come to Canada. And Canada has its own way of granting these to individuals like Tung who express an interest. So,
哇！原來咧呢啲coat of arms 或者勳章咧係好似我哋簡單嚟講啦，好似我哋嘅打冰棍球嘅球員咁樣啦，佢哋咧唔同嘅隊伍咧，即係最初嗰陣時啦，唔同嘅隊伍會著唔同嘅衫，其實係一個記型嚟。咁你知道咧，呢啲人咧係我哋自己嘅隊伍嘅，係嘛？我冇講錯啊？咁樣咧咁當然啦，咁呢一個係一個好老嘅 idea， 好耐之前就有㗎啦。咁啊，希望咧可以咧當事人希望可以用呢啲勳章或者徽章咧去代表自己嘅家族啦，或者係自己嘅團隊咁樣㗎。咁其實呢個 idea 都好舊㗎啦。其實喺加拿大呢一個勳章嘅制度有幾耐歷史啦？
呢個係1970幾年嗰陣時先過嚟嘅，就唔好耐嘅。咁咧就係屈先生咧，其實咧Robert 咧，佢係第一個我哋個首席嘅呢一個文章官係佢。咁啊係佢由佢一路搞起嚟嘅，喺加拿大嗰陣時。係英國皇室咧係頒嚟俾加拿大。咁加拿大總督咧，依家就承受咗個權力，可以頒發呢啲咁樣嘅。
所以都係一個英國嘅傳統嚟咗加拿大。
其實依家嚟講咧，就係批發呢個咧，最終嘅批發嘅權力咧，係仍然係要去到呢個英國皇室度嘅。譬如如果你話想用英國嘅皇冠啊，喺你嗰個文章入邊咧，就一定要有呢一個英女王嘅皇室咧親自批准嘅。咁所以普通人咧就淨係可以用其他啲唔同嘅形狀。
Okay. So tell us, you were the first person heading up the system. It's quite an accomplishment. Yes.
I was deeply honored because the government in 1987, actually, the planning got really underway. And it was the national government, then headed by Prime Minister Mulroney, and his Secretary of State, David Crombie, and his President of the Treasury Board, I think as he was, Mr. Mezenkowski, at the end. And David Crombie said to Prime Minister Mulroney, this is something that should be for all Canadians. Mm-hmm. Previously, it was done for 400 years. It was done, first of all, in Royal France, mm-hmm. and then in England. So for a long time in our history, it was an activity that happened in a legal sense, and even in an aesthetic sense, overseas. Mm-hmm. But it needed to be brought home here. And one of the important reasons was that it's accessible to all citizens, whatever their cultural background. Including, of course, the hundreds and hundreds of thousands of Canadians whose roots are in Chinese-speaking places in the world. And so very early on, with David Lam, for example, the former Lieutenant Governor of BC, he embraced this idea and recognized that these sorts of symbols could celebrate his life and his interests forever in his family. They would go on in time. Mm-hmm. And that's one of the keys. It's a celebration both of individual contribution to the community, but of a family tradition, because you're really starting something that's going to go on for centuries, a long way into the future.
原來呢啲文章啦，可以咧代俾你嘅家族啦，同埋咧去慶祝啦，或者係去 honor 你哋嘅成就咧，一路可以傳落去嘅，可以代代相傳嘅，咁其實咧都幾得意嘅。咁嗱，其實咧我自己睇呢啲文章嘅設計啊，同埋咧佢嗰個形式咧都好似好複雜咁啊，係咪？咁不如咧我又問下咧阿 Robert 咧呢啲其實呢一個文章咧大概有幾多部分啦，用啲咩組部分去組成嘅 ？So I did a little research. I've learned that there's a lot of parts to these coat of arms, so to
yes.
speak. Can you kind of explain to us what are the major parts?
The major part, the one that you get above all, is the shield. Mm-hmm. So you can be granted only a shield.
Oh.
And it can be granted to you in a lawful way, and we can explain that process in a bit. But the shield first. Mm-hmm. Then the helmet.
Oh, that's a helmet.
This is a helmet, traditional helmet. Mm-hmm. And then the cloth in two colors. It's highly stylized.
Oh.
But basically the origin is when knights were going into hot countries, they needed to be, their head needed to be protected from too much of a heat buildup. Oh. And the tradition grew up that in the principal colors of their shield, they would take pieces of silk and wrap them together and pull them over the top of the helmet, the metal helmet, to keep the temperature down inside.
So very practical.
This very practical. This is called mantling. Mm-hmm. And then the part above the helmet and the mantling is called the crest.
Mm-hmm.
And you often hear people talk about a family crest.
Yes.
What they're actually referring to is the whole coat of arms. But properly, this piece is called the crest here. And then below, you have the motto.
Mm-hmm.
There's always a motto. And you can be granted a shield and a motto only. And sometimes people are.
Mm-hmm.
And they start that way. And then later on, they decide, no, we'd like to have other elements too. So here, you see the heraldic flag.
Mm-hmm.
And you'll notice that it's exactly the same, exactly. It's just rebalanced to fit the square banner. This is a badge, and the badge is a separate thing.
Mm-hmm.
And before we started, I was giving an example. If somebody was in business and they had an employee recognition program, and they wanted to give something special to leading employees who had accomplished whatever, they might turn the badge into a pin, and then give that as a special award that only they could do because the badge is theirs.
So nobody
else can use it because it's granted by the crown, which is why this symbol is up here. Because the source, legally, of all these things is the Queen, as Queen of Canada. She gives the authority to the Governor General, who's here in his symbol, and then the heraldic authority, headed by the Chief Herald, is over here on this side. So always in these granting documents, you'll see the three up top. These never vary. These change with each Governor General.
Oh, I see.
Because each Governor General has their own coat of arms.
咁我咧睇到咧，喺呢一張嘅文章嘅證書啦，係咪可以咁講啊？證書上面咧，佢都好多部分組成，而每一個部分咧都有佢自己嘅含義。咁至於咧呢張文章究竟屬於邊個咧？而家休息一陣間，翻嚟咧再同大家揭曉。等陣翻嚟再見啦。 各位觀眾大家好，歡迎繼續收睇《大城小聚》。咁我繼續咧同阿 Mr. Watt 咧同埋阿聰咧傾下咧，哇！呢個文章制度好複雜啊，講三日都講唔曬。不過咧，同大家揭曉啦。咁其實我哋見到呢個藍色好靚好靚呢個文章嘅證書啦，係通佢哋自己本身嘅，係咪啊？攞咗幾耐到啊？
2012年6月已經攞到嘅啦，已經嚇。不過就冇公諸於世咁解啫。咁因為想大家同大家分享，等多啲人都可以考慮下申請。
有一樣嘢我覺得幾特別嘅，因為我見到咧，我以為通常呢啲證書咧係因為英國皇室派出嚟嘅、頒發出嚟嘅，有中文嘅喎、哦。係啊，其實我亦都唔係第一個有中文嘅，因為頭先佢Rob
都有講啦，就以前林思齊博士咧，佢嗰個私人嘅文章咧都係有中文兩個書嘅。咁其實中文係唔單止就可以用中文，可以用其他嘅語文都可以。咁當然我哋自己中國人啊嘛。 咁做呢一個，雖然呢度係西方社會，我哋加拿大嘅社會，但係有唔好忘本，所以點都要擺個中文落去。
So I was asking Tom, like, there's Chinese on it, like other languages allow as well?
Yes, yes. Any language known on earth. And already in the 25 years since the authority started, 1988, more than 25 now, we've had many, many. Chinese, of course. Korean, Japanese, Vietnamese, German, French and English, of course, Polish, Ukrainian, Farsi.
Oh, wow, anything, Farsi, any official language.
Any language that people have created. One of the ones that I remember particularly fondly was when I worked on the new coat of arms for Nunavut, the new territory in the north. There are two versions of Inuktitut. Written down in quite different ways, and we had to work with elders to translate the two versions of Inuktitut and Inuyaktun into heraldic language so we could write out the official document, which is in English and French and the two Inuit languages. But yes, that's a long answer.
Wow.
Any language. And of course, First Nations languages. University of Northern BC, for example, they wanted to honor the local First Nations people. They chose Carrier, and they consulted with the elders and said, this is the idea that we want to say. Tell us how to say it.
Wow, and that's so, quite interesting.
Yeah, no, it's fascinating, but
Another thing I noticed, 但我其實我睇到一樣嘢咧，我知道咧有啲文章咧係側邊係有兩隻動物嘅。 So I've noticed some of them got animals like kind of guarding or supporting the crest. How is that different?
Well, if we can use this one, this is a great one. Tung is going to hold it up. This is the Wong Association, Family Association from Toronto. And this grant they got several years ago. And you see the animals on either side are called supporters.
Oh, they support.
Because they support the shield. And if you're a corporate body, as they are, an incorporated body, in their case under the laws of Ontario, you're eligible to receive supporters. Some individuals, governors general, lieutenant governors, people who occupy the senior level in the national orders, like Order of Canada, they are also eligible to receive supporters. These are, I think, wonderful, because here you see the panda in honor of China, the polar bear in honor of Canada.
Ah, very symbolic.
The lower colors are classically red and gold, the most famous auspicious Chinese colors.
Colors ever?
Ever, yes, but you know, ancient in China. The dragon, interestingly, the Chinese dragon in this case is shown in the national colors of Canada. So they wanted to honor both their Chinese ancestral origins of the family and of their service to the community by using traditional Chinese colors, but also the national colors. And here you see the phoenix, the Chinese phoenix, with the Wang character in the medallion in gold and red, the traditional Chinese colors. And then the motto is in both Chinese and English, which is, again, a very good example of what you were talking about. So heraldry is not only in Canada for individuals, it's for corporations, business corporations, cultural societies, family associations, and golf clubs, and
any
that you can think of. The authority has granted to everybody, as widely separated as golf clubs out here, the Corel Corporation, the Bank of Montreal, you name it.
Yes. 原來呢啲文章咧，唔單止你個人可以申請喎，譬如你一啲組織啊、團體啊，或者係公司咧都可以申請噶。咁啊，講咗咁耐，好多家庭觀眾可能諗嚇。如果我想申請嘅話咧，點樣去申請呢？咁我等下問下Robert 啦。So let's say if somebody's interested in getting one of these coat of arms, how do they go through the process?
Well, the process is very straightforward, and they begin with a letter, which is called formally a petition, and they say basically, I so and so would like to receive a coat of arms from the Canadian Crown under the powers held by the Governor General. And it's a simple request like that. And they support it with their biography. Why the biography? Because it's part of the national honor system.
Ah.
It's an honor from the Canadian Crown from Rideau Hall. So the honorable part is, what have they done reaching out beyond themselves to make a contribution to the community? So it's a matter of merit. You can ask, but you have to be found eligible. So in your case, for example, if you decided to do this, you would begin looking at merit from the point of view of this service that you do as a broadcaster, as a TV journalist, as an interviewer, because through your work, you reach out to tens of thousands of people who are looking at you, you know, every week or whatever. So it's that. So it's not a simple ask. It's an ask related to community service, and it's supported by the biography, and you have to provide two references. So that letter goes in, the Chief Herald looks at it, she develops a recommendation to the Governor General's secretary or the secretary's deputy. If they agree, they put their stamp on it, and say, yes, go ahead. And now we sit down with Emily, and keeping you as the example, and then the real enjoyment and fun begins, because the questions are, okay, you're going to have one of
these. I get to get one now, let's say.
So you've been found eligible. So then the discussions go on while you say, okay, what is it about my life that I really want to have symbolized? What are my favorite colors? And in heraldry, you've got limited colors. You've got two what are called metals, gold and silver, yellow and white.
That's true.
And here you see gold and blue, and five colors, blue, red, green, purple, and black. And the trick is using your preferences to come up with the design, because you also say, I really like cats, for example. I have a cat and I want to have a cat somewhere. How can I do that? And so the discussion goes back and forth, and it's an intimate collaboration until you reach the point where you've got a concept.
Yeah.
And then that's put into art form.
Oh my gosh.
And then you look at it, and that's when you say, yep, I like 80% of that.
And then you tweak it.
20%, I'm not sure. So you tweak it, indeed.
Okay. The important questions then. How long does it take and how much? Is it a very long, elaborate, expensive process?
12 to 14 months, so a year to 14 months, typically, if everything goes smoothly. They tend to become a family project, so quite often there are children or siblings that are involved in the discussion. Even though it's a grant to you, they will have an obvious interest.
Right, because it's a family tradition.
Because it's a family thing. And the cost is typically between about $3,000 and $4,500.
Oh, that's quite a big range.
Yeah. But and the range is largely related to how much art is involved.
I see.
Because most of the cost is in the artwork, not in the discussion stage anything.
So like it's actual design of
the actual design and the rendering. And if you choose this form of the granting document, it's done by hand.
All by hand.
Every millimeter of it is by hand. So fabulous piece of art.
To hang at home, it certainly beats a painting.
Yeah.
哇，原來咧，我哋見到呢個Mr. Tung Chan 嗰幅證書咧，係全部係人手畫落去嘅。咁所以我哋剛才講嗰個價錢咧，好多都係做設計上面啦，同埋咧去。印啊，或者去即係真係製作呢個證書嘅過程㗎。咁咧，而家咧，我哋又休息一陣間，等陣咧翻嚟咧，最緊要咧就同Mr. Tung Chan講下佢個人嘅經歷。哇！佢點解咁叻嘅，可以受到皇室頒一個勳章啊，或者文章俾佢㗎。咁我哋休息一陣間，等陣翻嚟再見啦。各位觀眾大家好，歡迎繼續收睇《大城小聚》。咁剛才咧就講咗你點樣可以申請一個呢啲咁嘅文章啦。咁其實咧都唔係咁容易嘅，你要喺社會上面一定嘅地位啦，或者貢獻等等咧嚇，要造福人群啦，基本上咧先至可以獲得批准嘅，因為呢個係個榮譽嚟嘅。咁基本上你見到有朋友，如果佢可以擁有一個咁嘅文章嘅話咧，都係社會上嘅成功人士啦。所以我哋今日好開心咧，請到阿通咧，又係我哋環之光啦，可以攞到個學校證書嚇，即係代表呢個國家對你嘅承認咁樣，咁其實又想問下啦，我知道咧，原來呢啲嘢咧都係申請嘅，你自己係幾時申請或者幾時得到呢一個文章㗎啦？
申請其實都經過一段時間嘅，我喺2010年嘅六月咧就已經申請㗎啦，咁啊去到2012年咧嘅六月，然後足足兩年，咁但係當然啦，嗰兩年之中咧，我因為自己有出咗門啊，所以冇時間咁。其實嗰陣時咧，就因為我同Rob 係好朋友啦，咁佢同我講起，我話咦都幾有興趣喎，咁亦都係想效法下呢一個林小齊博士咧，佢自己都有。咁就最重要咧，就係因為咧，我覺得咧，如果要攞到呢啲咁樣嘅文章嘅時候咧，即係代表咗自己同埋我自己家族咧，真係融入咗呢個加拿大。因為呢啲係雖然話係難攞，但係其實咧就係有貢獻嘅人士咧，譬如貢獻係點樣定義咧？
佢
好廣泛嘅定義，譬如好似頭先阿 Robert 講嘅，你作為一個播音嘅藝人，
傳媒人
咁樣，傳媒人士咁樣講咧，你每個星期都向廣大嘅群眾係播發好多好好嘅消息，咁呢個係一個加拿大嘅貢獻嚟噶嘛，咁你都有資格申請嘅。同埋一樣嘢咧，就係因為咧，就攞咗呢個之後咧，真係好好噶，因為傳宗世代啊，因為我哋中國人嚟講，好多時都有啲全家之寶噶嘛，
咁呢個就
係啦，文化遺產啦，咁呢個變咗全家之寶啊，咁所以變咗咧，我覺得係好值得去攞咯。
一路可以 pass 落去㗎。
係啊，嗱，所以你見到咧喺呢度咧，就見咗有其中除咗呢個係俾我自己之外咧，連我兩個女嘅名都喺書嚟。
啊，係喎，見到呢兩係你個女。
係啦，呢個我哋。
但係個圖案又有少少
有少少唔同嘅，就係點樣樣咧？就呢個咧係我大女嘅圖案嚟嘅，咁咧就在我在生之時咧，佢個圖案咧就根本嚟講咧同我一模一樣，
基本上係一樣嘅，
只不過多咗完全一樣，只不過多咗呢一行響書。 咁咧就變咗咧，如果我唔在世嘅時候咧，佢就可以將呢個取消。咁依家由佢咧，亦都存在俾佢嘅後一代。
即可以一路一代代咁傳落去嘅。
係啊，一路傳落去啦。咁呢個咧就係我細女嘅。
哦，咁就唔同樣噶咯。
唔同樣啦，咁就唔同樣咧。其實個設計完全一樣。嗱，你見到亦都係有三個海龜喺樹。咁仲喺個邊度咧？係有唔同嘅，
啊係喎，少少
佢咧亦都可以咧一路咁樣傳落去啦。咁呢啲咁樣咧，其實你買都買唔到噶嘛，
有錢都買唔到，
有錢買唔到啊。咁但係你可以申請攞到，加拿大係一個好公平嘅地嘅國家。咁只要你係對呢個國家有多少嘅貢獻嘅時候咧，去申請咧，咁係可以攞到。咁變咗就真係覺得自己啊，我喺呢度。真係落葉生根啦！我有我自己嘅一個咁樣嘅文章出嚟啦。
咁即係主流社會都亦都非常之接受你嘅貢獻啦，同埋你嘅成就啦，係嘛？
可以咁樣講啦。
咁都其實一個啊華人嚟講都係一個幾難得嘅一個榮譽或者光榮嚟嘅。咁但我留意到咧嚇，好細微嘅嘢，你今日著嘅衫上面咧就有一個襟章喺你心口嘅。呢一個咧又好似呢個盾喎，可以咁用㗎？
可以咁樣用㗎。其實咧就我就將呢一個個盾咧係做咗一個咁樣嘅。個係徽章出嚟，自己戴住，咁亦都咧可以俾，譬如話你對朋友，佢覺得佢啊，你都對得我幾好啊，咁可以俾你，咁嗱呢個俾你啊，咁呢個係
多謝你嚇，咁我亦都可以戴嘅，
係啦，
即係可以戴出街嘅，
可以戴出街嘅，係啊，完全冇問題嘅，咁即係變咗係咁樣嘅時候咧，變咗可以多一樣嘢去俾人哋咯，就多謝人哋啊，或者係自己家人啊，咁可以戴出嚟可以見到。
咁其實最初嗰陣時，你去申請係你自己自己嘅 idea， 因為有朋友啊、家庭成員去鼓勵你咁樣噶。
當然啦，就因為Robin 叔啦，咁佢亦都以前
，yes，
佢亦都係以前嘅首席嘅呢個文章官啦，咁做過好多經驗嘅。咁所以我同佢坐低，唔單止我同佢坐低講，我捉埋我兩個女咧，同埋我太太咧一齊同佢傾偈嘅。咁咧點解咧？因為呢一個係家傳世代落去噶嘛，咁所以都要有佢哋嘅意見。咁其實你見到咧呢個設計入邊咧好多嘢咧都係有埋佢哋嘅意見喺書嚟
嘅。咁剛才Robert 就講過，其實呢個設計咧係呢個文章嘅主人咧有好大嘅 influence 或者影響嘅。咁你自己喺設計你呢個文章上面咧，你點解去選擇譬如海龜啊，或者係藍色啊，或者嗰只係咪紅咧咁樣咧？
嗱，逐個講啊，咁啊先講呢個冠先啦嚇。咁呢個頂呢度咧，其實即係個 BC 省嘅紅嚟㗎。
哦。
咁啊初嗰陣時，因為我哋住響 BC 省啦。
係。
啊，咁初嘅設計咧，其實咧就呢只紅咧係張牙。
係惡
嘅，好惡嘅嚇！咁我兩個女女係啦，好惡嘅，開曬眼啊！咁但係我兩個女話：爹哋，你唔係咁嘅人啫，我哋一家人都唔係咁惡嘅啫。咁所以即係改咗，變咗咧，你見到咧，其實好有笑容嘅呢只紅，
有少少笑容嘅，係啊，眼神唔係犀利啲啫，
係啦，唔係犀利啊！咁啊嚇，咁所以就咁樣有隻咁嘅 BC 嘅紅人啊。
點解揦住個紙咧？
嗱，揦住咧就係咧呢個書卷嚟嘅。因為我哋姓陳一家一早幾代落嚟都係有進士啊，有舉人啊，有教書先生咁，所以個個都書香世代，咁咪攞住啲書啦。咁好啦，點解呢度仲有個月桂花喺度？咁同埋有個海，有個鰻喺度咧？
係啦，
就因為我係依一個加拿大皇家海軍嘅上校啊嘛，咁所以咧就特別有個鰻喺書嚟嘅。好啦。咁呢一度呢條扎花咧係咩嚟嘅咧？其實就是香港啊個市花嚟嘅，代表我自己係啦，冇錯，因為我喺香港嚟啊嘛，咁所以擺咗呢個落去。咁你見到呢個咧，係咪全部咧代表我嘅嚟嘅地方啦？好啦，咁點解會呢度有個盾入邊有三隻海龜咧？
好中意游水啊！
好游水嗱，第一就因為我哋係經過海過嚟啦，
啊，
喺呢個香港過嚟。經過太平洋過咗嚟呢度，咁所以係個海嘅龜咧。點解有海龜咧？我爺爺咧就喺深圳啊行醫，佢係中醫嚟嘅。咁因為深圳咧近住呢個海邊噶嘛，好多時咧啲漁民咧就不慎咁望到啲海龜翻嚟。咁我爺爺咧就去同佢買咗海龜，然後放生嘅。咁變咗啲海龜走嘅時候好得意嘅喎，我聽我爺爺講咧，就佢啲海龜走咧唔係就咁就走嘅。出咗去之後，佢遊翻翻轉頭嚟。
嚇，點解啊？
去鞠躬三下。
真係啊！
係啊，佢咁講啦，我自己未見過。咁所以咧，為紀念咧，我哋爺爺係做善事咧，咁咧就擺呢三隻海龜喺樹。嗱，咁呢個格言咧亦都係啦，積善之家。咁呢個係其實點樣咧？就係我哋嘅陳氏嘅祠堂，我哋自己就喺呢個大鵬城啦。個祠堂外邊係有一對對聯嘅。嗰對對聯咧就係積善之家。必有餘慶。嗱，咁我加個少少嘅古仔啦。呢啲嘅中文字係邊個寫嘅咧？係阿劉國凡先生咧，係幫我寫落去㗎。
哦，即係唔係佢哋啲人寫嘅。
唔係佢哋啲人寫，其他所有咧都係佢哋嗰啲藝術家咧。 同我畫出嚟，但係呢個字咧就劉國雲先生同我寫，呢度亦都係一字之隔。
咁
但係英文咧嘅格言咧係同個中文係唔同嘅。
係啦，唔係 translation 嚟㗎喎。
唔係，但係咧又有關係嘅喎。點解咧？因為職善之家其實都係一個服務啊，係做善事嘅地方。咁而呢一個 honour in service 咧 ，service 咧就係話我哋服務人群嘅。因為我自己是做過銀行是服務行業做過市議員亦都是服務大眾我太太是護士她是服務人的我仔女 是律師她也是服務人士我的大女也在這個 BC 省政府裡面是做事的亦都是服務人所以我們選擇這個是 Honor in Service 這個是我們的格言
哇！所以佢成個呢啲圖誒，成個設計咧，都真係好多元素，要諗好多嘢去考慮，即係點樣用你嘅背景啊，或者係一啲歷史啊，融合去一個設計咁樣嘅。冇錯，
咁亦都係等於啦，就話你申請嘅時候，將自己嘅故事帶出嚟，將自己個家嘅邊啲係重要嘅價值觀咧，可以帶出嚟。咁變咗，同埋仲有最緊要就係話，因為有呢個咁樣嘅格言喺度，座右銘喺度，有呢個古仔喺度，咁變咗世世代代都知道原來原來我哋祖先係咁樣。
阿爺係咁嘅，太公係哇好犀利嘅太公。
咁就呢個好事咯。
嗯，咁等我又問下阿 Robert 啦。So where can you use these coat of arms, or is there a limitation on where you can put them?
No limitation really.
Can I tattoo it on or something?
Yes, yeah, we've had that, tattoos. Most people start with their business card, particularly if they're entrepreneurs.
Tung
has a perfect example. You can turn it into a pin. I was talking about a person who had a business corporation with employee recognition, so you can use the shield or the badge. You can fly your flag on a boat,
真係可以有支旗。
Or in a summer property, you can make a book plate. All sorts of, some people make, if they have a blazer, they make a fabric badge and put it on the pocket of their blazer. People create rings, they create cufflinks, they create, I remember a man whose roots were in Japan, but he was born in Canada, and one of his daughters married a person whose roots were in Scotland, and so her husband-to-be was wearing a kilt at the wedding, and he decided that as a special gift to his daughter, he would get a sash pin, classic Scottish style pin, but with his badge, with the mon that we created for him. So, you know,
anything
lots of jewelry.
Yeah.
Really the only limitation is whatever you do it in good taste. So if you do a t-shirt, for example, you find a good t-shirt manufacturer who's gonna treat the symbol well and properly. That's the key.
好，咁咧今日咧真係多謝曬咧上兩位上嚟介紹咗呢個文章嘅制度，大家可以諗下考慮下自己咧有冇資格去申請一個，如果可以嘅話咧，申請一個做全家之寶，好似阿通咁咧都非常之好噶。咁我而家真係多謝曬 Robert 同埋通咧，同我哋分享咗咁多。今日節目時間又夠啦，下次節目時間再同大家見啦，拜拜。